Good morning, students. My name is Meena and I am taking your chemistry in this year. Okay. So, first of all, we can just go through what are the chapters that comes under chemistry. Okay. So, first chapter, that is chapter 1, matter in our surrounding. Chapter 2 is matter around us pure. And chapter 3, atoms and molecules. And the last chapter, that is chapter 4, structure of atoms. Okay, students, we can start with our first chapter. That is matter in our surrounding. Okay. So, in this chapter, you will be basically dealing with what do you mean by matter, what are the different types of matter, how the matter is made up of, what are the different states of matter, like that. Okay. So, now we can just go to what do you mean by matter, or where the matter is present. Okay. So, as the name suggests itself, we can say that matter is matter in our surrounding. That is, we can say that matter is present in our surrounding itself, isn't it? So, we can just go through how the concept of matter came into our science. Okay. That is, in the earlier cases, the scientists, when they tried to learn about the surrounding, they found that everything, whether it is a non-living thing or living thing, all the things that are present in our surrounding or that are present in our universe is made up of a particular substance, and they named that particular substance as matter. Okay, that is, they said that all the living things and non-living, or all the substance in the universe, are made up of matter. Okay, and they gave a definition for matter, that is, the substance that has mass and occupies space. Okay, that was the definition for matter. So, the matter is something, a substance, if it has a mass and it occupies a space, we can say that it comes under matter, it is a matter. Okay, so for example, chair, table, books, rocks, sand, all those things comes under matter. Isn't it? Why? Because they have a particular mass and they also occupies what? A space. What about water, that is liquids? They may also contain what? They have a particular mass and they also occupies what? Space. Okay, so they also comes under matter. So, they are also what? Matters. What about the air, that is gases? They also have mass, isn't it? And they also occupies what? A space. So, that also comes under what? Matter. So, whatever the substance that are present in the universe or that are present in our surrounding comes under or are made up of matter. Or we can see that all the substance that are present in our universe are known as or are, which can be called as matter. Okay. Okay. So, the next is that how the matter is classified. Okay. I have already said that in the earlier times what happened when the scientists, when they tried to learn about the surrounding, they found that everything was made up of a common thing and they named it as what? Matter. So, according to that, that is according to the earlier stage, they said that they classify the matter into the 5 basic forms. That is, they believe that everything, that is whether it be a living thing or non-living thing, everything in the surrounding is made up of 5 basic elements. Okay. What are the 5 basic elements? Air, earth, fire, sky and water. And they name this as Panchatattva, or it is also known as Panchabhuta. Okay. So, according to that, they believe that the substance or the things that is around, that is present in our surrounding is made up of this 5 basic elements. Okay. Okay. So, as you know that the science is developing day by day. So, what happens after a long time? What happens? The modern scientists, they make a change in the classification of matter. That is, they classify the matter on the basis of their physical property and on the basis of the chemical property. Okay. So, in this chapter, we will be dealing with how the matter is classified on the basis of their physical property. Now, we can study about the nature of matter. Okay. So, at that time, while studying about the nature of matter, there were two conclusions. That is, one is that the matter is, that is, a group of people says that the matter is continuous. That is, it cannot be divided further. It will be as such. Okay. And the another group says that the matter is particulate. That is, it can be again divided. Okay. So, we can do one experiment. and from that it will be clear, that is, you will get the answer for this question. Okay, that is, whether the matter is continuous or whether it is particulate. Okay, so for that, here I am taking a small amount of water, and to that I am adding a sugar crystals. Okay, so just go through the size of the sugar crystal. Okay, that is, it is very very small. Okay, now this water is a type of matter and the sugar is another type of matter. Okay, so I am adding the sugar to this water. So what happens after some time? After some time, we can see that the sugar crystals will get dissolved in the water, isn't it? So after some time, can we see the sugar crystal? No. But whether the sugar is present there? Yes, sugar is present there. That is, when we taste the water, we can feel the sweetness. So from that, it is confirmed that the sugar crystals are present in the water. So where does the sugar crystal go? That is the answer for this question. Okay. That is, they say that when we are adding the sugar crystal to water, what happened is that the water molecules will break the sugar crystal into tiny particles. That is, the water molecules will break the sugar crystals into tiny particles. That is, sugar is a type of matter. So here what happens, that matter is divided into tiny particles. So from that experiment, it is clear that the matter is not continuous, it is a particulate. That is, it matter can be again divided. Okay, now we can look towards the size of the particle. Okay, so we have already studied that the matter is made up of particles. Now we can study about the size of the particle, how small the particles are. Okay, so for that we can do an activity. That is, here I am taking a small amount of water and I am taking an yellow color substance. Okay, so what happens when this yellow color substance is added to water? The whole water will turn to what color? This yellow color, even though the amount of substance is very low when compared to the amount of water. Okay, but what happens? The whole water will turn to yellow color, isn't it? So I am adding this. So what happens? The whole water, that is, that whole waters will becomes what color? Will become yellow color. So how this is possible? That is, we are adding only a small amount of yellow substance to the large amount of water, isn't it? But the whole substance has, that is, the whole amount of water becomes what color? That yellow color. So how this is possible? That is, they say that even though the substance, that is yellow color substance, even though the substance is small, that is, even though the amount of substance is very small, but the particles that is present in that substance is big. That is, it contains millions of particles. Okay, so that's why it happens like this. Okay, now we can do another activity. Okay, so here I am taking a small amount of water and a very small amount of blue color ink. Okay, that is, when compared to the amount of water, this amount of ink is very less. Okay, so what happens when we are adding this ink? What happens? The whole color of that water will become the color of the ink. Here also we are adding only a small amount of ink, but it has changed the whole amount of water, isn't it? So why this happens? The same explanation for this, that is, even though the amount of ink is very small, but the particles that is present in are big. That is, the millions of particles are present in the small amount of ink. Okay. Okay, so in your text, that is activity 1.2, what they are saying? They are saying a potassium, small amount of potassium permanganate is added to the water. So what happens? Definitely, the entirely the color of the water will become what color? The color of the potassium permanganate. Okay. Then after that, what they are saying? They are keeping on dilution. Okay. So what happens on dilution? The color faded, but the color is present there. Okay. So which shows that the particles of potassium permanganate are present there. Okay. So the same activity can be done can be done. Let us here I am taking a ring solution that we have already done in the previous activity. Okay, so here I am making it dilute. Okay, so how to dilute? That is, for this I am taking small amount of water, and to that a pure water is added. That is, I am diluting this solution. Okay, so we can just check whether the color is present or not. Okay, yes, the color is present, isn't it? Still the color is present on adding a pure water. Still the color is present there. That is, we can say that the particles of ink are present here. Now just compare the color of this both the liquid. It is just get faded, only the color becomes faded. Okay, but still the particles are present. So from all this activity we can say that if we are taking a small amount of substance, but that small amount of substance contain what? A millions of particles. Now just imagine the size of the particle. And another example is that if just take a crystal of sugar. Okay, you can imagine what is the size of the crystal of sugar. It's very small. And they say that in each crystal it contains a millions of particles. Okay, so here also when in your text they are taking potassium permanganate, and when we are taking a crystals of potassium permanganate, that is when we are taking a piece of potassium permanganate, it says that that piece or that crystals of potassium permanganate contains a millions of particles. Okay, so because of this number, that is because of the huge number of particles, as we dilute the solution, it still the particles are present because the number of particles is huge, a large number, it's a million of particles are present there. Okay, so now just imagine the size of the particle. That is, the size of the particle is very 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 small. That is, it is beyond our imagination. Okay, so the next property, that is, particles of the matter have space between them. That is, in between the particle they will maintain a space. Okay, for that we can do an activity. Here I am taking a small amount of water, and to that I am adding a yellow color substance. Okay, so what happens when I am adding the yellow color substance? The whole solution will becomes what color? Yellow color, isn't it? And when we observe that, we can see that the yellow particles, we can see everywhere the yellow particle, that is, the yellow particles are evenly distributed. Okay, and this is possible only if there is an empty space between them. That is, if there is an empty space, only the particles, that yellow particles, will come and locate in the empty space, isn't it? So here we can see that the yellow particles are evenly distributed. That is, it is located throughout the solution. So we can say that there occurs a large empty space in the water. As a water is a type of matter, so we can say that the particles of the matter have what? And empty space. Okay, so we have studied that the particles of the matter have space between them. Okay, just suppose, think that this is a water molecules. Okay, and the particles that is present in the water, each particles have what? Space between them. And this is a yellow substance. It may also have particle, and they have space between them. That is, this is a space. Just imagine that this is the space. So what happens when the two matters, when the two different types of matter, when we are adding, what they happen? They will get intermixed with each other, isn't it? How this intermix takes place? Only because of the space, isn't it? So from that it is clear that the matter or the particles in the matter have space between them. Okay, if there is no space, what happens? Whether it will get intermixed? No. But what happens actually when we are adding a substance, it will be evenly distributed, or it will get evenly intermixed. So how does it happen? This happens because of the space that occur in the particles. So particles of the matter have space between them. Okay.